How many of you have seen this guy's video? 8 years ago, this guy went for the Nigerian Got Talent audition.
Hi, my name is Emmanuel Udeh. 8 years ago, I went for Nigerian Got Talent and I failed woefully.
Sorry. It's just 1 year and 2 no's, so your show ends here. Sorry.
Thank you.
I can leave this thing.
My name is Emmanuel Udeh. I'm an indigent of Delta, Ebonyi State, but I'm residing in Asaba. So I came here to win everybody and collect the 10 million.
How old are you, Emmanuel?
I'm 22 years old.
22. And what are you going to do for us?
I'm going to present my talent. I'm going to dance.
Okay, you do a presentation of your talent, okay? Emmanuel, the stage is yours. Show us your talent.
Showcase the talent to move to the next level.
Okay, you want to move to the next level.
What are you going to do on the next level?
I'm going to do more than this.
Okay, the judges will decide that, not you. Let's see if you're going to move to the next level. Dan?
No.
It's a no from me.
All right,
I'm sorry.
Well, sorry.
Emmanuel, can you tell us how did you find out about the Nigeria Got Talent audition and what inspired you to go for that very audition?
Okay, it all happened 8 years ago when I was at home washing my clothes and somebody just came home with a flyer and was saying that they are doing an audition on Nigeria Got Talent, that if you are interested to go, that you should go. So right then, when I was in primary school and secondary school, I usually danced so much so that I got first in any competition that we are going. So I now said I can do it. Let me just go and give it a try. So I went for the audition, and from there, I was qualified to go to Lagos for the main competition, yes. Then from there, all the whole story happened. You understand? Honestly, let me tell you, I did not prepare for it.
You didn't prepare for the audition?
I did not prepare for it. You understand? I just think in my mind that this dance is my thing. It's my thing. I didn't know. I know how to dance. You understand?
Yeah. Okay. You weren't expecting the competition to be hard pressed. You weren't expecting that a lot of people come there, and your dancing wouldn't really stand out the way you thought it would.
Though I saw a lot of people that were registering for the same dance. You understand? But I said, let me just give it a try and know what will come out of it.
Oh. We all saw you cry in that very video. So can you tell us what made you cry?
Okay.
I mean, since you didn't prepare for the performance, why did you cry when the judges told you no?
What actually happened is that I prayed over it when I was going. And there was a strong belief in my heart that said I should go. You understand? So, but then I now selected a song on my phone. Back then I was using a small phone, but it can play a song. Some Christian song were there and some worldly song were there. So I now selected some song with Jesus name. In Jesus name, like I closed my eye and I was scrolling and selected it. So unfortunately the song I selected with that thing I imagined that it will work for me was that that song, because I love playing that song. But I went there, I didn't know that I was supposed to be dancing and not singing, so I was singing the song and also moving my leg trying to dance and all those things.
Can you dance for us now? Why?
I don't dance again.
Why?
I don't dance like
since then. You no longer dance.
Even in church, if I'm in church, before you see me dance, maybe the music has entered somewhere, I'll just stand up and be shaking my leg, but I no longer dance.
You no longer dance anymore. Maybe we could dance together now. No, let's try. Stand. This is an interview. Let's try. Don't worry, I'll dance with you. I'll dance with you. Come
no,
on.
No.
Bro, let's do this. Why?
I don't like dancing.
You don't like dancing. So after that competition, you stop dancing.
It's not that I stop dancing.
You just prefer not to dance. Okay, won't you dance for my followers? They want to see. I think that some of them would like to see you dance. Maybe they want to see if you've improved.
How will I improve something I did not get well then? What will I improve it for? I stopped dancing long time ago.
Okay. Alright, so Emmanuel, so tell me, how has life been for you ever since that very competition?
Okay. You know, I was doing one work then. You understand? I was cleaning the court in government house, and they were paying me 15,000 then. So life was good for me then, because as of then, even up till now, life is still good for me. There was never a time I struggled, though I have some people that stand there for me. But after that video, I started, as in, people started, if anywhere I go, people say, I watch your video, email. So something like that. So I was too much ashamed of myself that I went to something like this and all those things.
So you're ashamed because after that very competition, people see you on the road and they'll say, I recognize you from that very video.
Yes.
And you were not happy about it.
I was not happy about it.
Why?
Because whenever I...
Were they laughing at you?
So we just pass, and then if they are passing you, we know that they are talking about you. They will just, you see a kind of laugh, like they will just laugh. This guy is not serious, idiot. You don't go disgrace yourself, something like that. So that is what was going through almost all the people that I meet that watched my video. Then there was one guy in my compound. His name is Christian. I said I must make sure his name here.
Christian, I hope they are watching.
But he's no longer living in the compound. No.
It doesn't matter, but definitely he's going to see this video.
So every time he sees me, he just call me Emmanuel Udeh. He was just using me and my name to play, you understand? He just call me Emmanuel Udeh. I'm an indigent of Asaba. You know, back then I made a mistake when I was telling them where I came from.
My name is Emmanuel Udeh. I'm an indigent of Delta, Ebonyi State.
So he will just use it as a caricature every time. Emmanuel Udeh,
he will be repeating what he said in that.
Yes, and those things used to annoy me. So anytime I see him saying, I will just go inside and close the house and stay. I'll just be thinking about my life.
Yeah, so I think that you did what a lot of people cannot and can never do in their entire life. What you did was courageous, you know, even though you didn't prepare so much and you put all of your hope in prayer. There's nothing wrong with praying, you know, it's a good thing that as Christians we should pray, but I believe that we should all pray for whatever it is we are working for. Do you understand? And then that's how it ought to be. I think that you've inspired a lot of people. I think that there are a lot of people who are just like Emmanuel, that if this same opportunity were given to them, they probably would have ignored it because of how they look. I think that for Emmanuel to have gone for that very competition, it tells a lot about him. He's a courageous person. Unfortunately, he didn't pass, but he had courage and he has created history for himself, whether he sees it that way or not. So, Emmanuel, so what about your family? How did they react to the video?
If I tell you something, you will not believe. This side I'm about to tell you, make sure you post it. Because my mother is not using an Android phone. Though I plan buying it for her, she's using an ordinary phone. But my father is late. But since then, my mother has not watched it. My mother has not known even my village. I went home this Christmas, and all the whole Christmas I've been going home. I've not seen anybody in the village that talk about my video or say, "Emma, we saw your video." So I was shocked. You know, when I was the first time I did all this, I did those mess on the because I'll call it a mess on the Nigerian Got Talent. My
created history. You don't have to call it a mess.
Okay. My fear was, what will my family, what will my hometown, what will they see me and say, and how will they look at me? So when I was going home for Christmas, I was going home as a person that will stay indoor all through the Christmas. So I went.
Okay, your plan was that if you go home for Christmas, you just remain indoors. Yes. Because you thought that your family, the people living in your village, they have all seen the video.
Yes.
But none of them even saw that video up till today.
Maybe they have seen it. You understand? Maybe they have seen it, but I have not seen anybody approach me in the village and maybe say, "Tell me, Ma, we have seen your video where you're crying or something." You understand? Maybe they have seen it. Maybe somebody, you know. No, mostly I will not. Mostly in the village, you will not see anybody. As in, if you see anybody using Android phone or those ones, big boys. Even when they were playing a match, because we usually play Christmas match, I decided to go and watch. There was nobody that approached me.
Nobody talked about the video.
Yes, nobody that approached me and said, "Emma, we saw the video." It's only here in Asaba that I will just stay like this, and somebody will just, "Emma, we saw your video. You just be laughing. You just play it for me." I don't know what that thing was doing to me. Yeah.
When you see people come to you and say, "Emmanuel, we saw your video online," just laugh. Bro,
see,
you created this.
Let me tell you what happened. What? Because that guy that I told you about, and some of my hostel mates then, you understand, they made me conquer my fear. They are bullying and all those things. Right now, I don't give a damn, because I don't usually watch my video. But right now, I'm even posting it on Instagram, on my page. I'm even posting it on TikTok, on YouTube. Because I've seen that. I've come to realize that it's not only me that done something like this before. I've seen people done worse. You understand?
So I've risen above
my bully and all those things. So I know if they just come, I will just, "Yes, it's me." Before, if they come, I'll tell them it's not me. They will say, "Is you?" I say, "No, it's not me." They'll say, "Is you?" I say, "No, it's not me." But now, if you just show me, I say, "Yes, it's me. It's me." So there's nothing to fear again. There's nothing to
Yeah, you know, that was 8 years ago and you were still young. And a lot of people watching this video, when they were young just like you, they made more painful mistakes. So I think what you did was you created history. You were very courageous, and I would want to say that you are an inspiration to all people who are also just like you. The only thing was that you didn't win. That video has over 11 million views on YouTube. So my friend, you've created history, and I want you to be confident. If somebody comes to you and say, Emmanuel, we saw your video, I want you to say, yes, that's me, and that happened 8 years ago. Okay, so let's walk, let's take a walk together. Emmanuel, can you tell us, what are you currently doing at the moment?
Okay, at the moment, I'm selling fish.
Oh, you sell fish?
Yes, I sell dry fish. Yes, that's my business.
Okay, can you take us to the place where you sell the fish?
Mostly, my business is contact. I don't stay in the market.
Okay, you don't have a shop?
Yes, I don't have a shop. I usually, if somehow, like some of my friends I have in WhatsApp, like if they just need fish, dry fish, I post the ones I bought them, and I posted it on listing on social media like WhatsApp. Then anybody that just need, they will just call me. Ma, we need dry fish. Then I will call my mother in the village. Then she will wait it. I'll go to Onisha and carry it.
Okay, so how old are you presently?
Okay, October last year was my 33rd birthday. I'm 33 right now.
So by October this year, 2022, you are going to be 34 years old?
Yes.
Okay, so Emmanuel presently, he's a businessman. What he does is that he sells fish, dried fish. And he doesn't have a physical shop. When somebody places an order for a fish, after he has posted pictures of the fishes on his WhatsApp status, he'll have to inform his mother in the village to send some fish to Webilit to him here in Delta State, and then he'll sell and make profits. But Emmanuel, with this business you are doing currently, where do you see yourself in? Do you have any challenge? I would like to first ask, do you have any challenge, and where do you see yourself in 3 years' time?
This is not the business I want to continue like forever, you understand?
Okay, you're just doing it to survive, just to keep yourself going.
Though I had a business I was doing before, but this is a business that is just giving me money to feed, you understand, right now. Then my plan is to set up a mini supermarket and also a restaurant in my town. That is my plan, and I'm saving towards it.
So that's impressive. That's impressive. So if you'd like to support Emmanuel, that would be cool. Emmanuel has a dream that someday he's going to own his own supermarket, and he will no longer have to sell fish to survive. So can you tell us, are you in a relationship?
No.
You're not in a relationship presently?
Yes.
But what happened to your past relationship?
I don't have any relationship since then.
You've never dated anybody since they born gave birth to you?
I would just call it a friendship when I was in secondary school, but it was not that serious. Since then I don't have any relationship.
So you've never dated anybody since you came to this world?
I'll just call it friend. I have friend one lady like that back then in my state.
How old were you then?
Then I was in secondary school. I should say like 15, 16 then.
Okay, I wouldn't consider that a relationship. Are you saying it's your personal decision that you want to continue being single, or are you having challenges finding a partner I mean, this is social media. Anybody could see you, and you know, you don't know.
Having challenge finding a partner. You understand? I just don't want now.
Okay, but if somebody's eyeing you right now, should I encourage the person to come to your DM?
No.
Okay, the person should not come to your DM.
Yes.
Why now? You don't want to mingle, or you don't want to?
It's a personal decision. So when I'm ready, I'll know.
Okay.
Right now, anything wrong? You have to stand with two legs first before you're looking for another weight on top of your body. So right now, I'm standing on one leg. You see, I'm not balanced.
But I don't think every woman out there is like that, you know. You just have to find the right person, someone that will make you happy and, you know, keep you company.
Emmanuel, I'll just say I have friends, you understand? I have friends that I chat with, discuss with, but I don't have any serious relationship right now.
Alright, okay, I think so. That'll be all for now. Meanwhile, yeah, so that'll be all for now. So any other thing, I'll say it after this video shoots.
After the interview I had with Emmanuel, I discovered that this guy doesn't even have followers. So I decided I was going to help him create a Facebook page. The original video of that very competition has 11 million views, and yet not too many persons know how to find Emmanuel. So I helped him to create a Facebook page, and I also tagged him from my page, and in less than 24 hours, Emmanuel now has over 1,500 followers and more still counting. So I'm going to invite Emmanuel to my place. He'll be here for some time. I'm going to teach him content creation, how to manage his page, because he'll be the one managing it. I think that someone like Emmanuel should be supported. This is my opinion. Strong people stand up for themselves. Why stronger people stand up for other people? It would be a noble thing if we consider Emmanuel as somebody who deserves certain attention. I mean, years back, everybody was laughing at him, and now we all can get access to Emmanuel. So I'm gonna say that if we can, let's watch his videos, and if there's any way we can support him to achieve his dreams faster, that would be a really noble thing for us. I'm gonna support him in my own way. I have no business with his page. He'll be the one managing it. His phone number is gonna be here, so do not come to me to inquire anything about Emmanuel. You can speak to him directly. Okay, I don't want to be the middleman or anything. My intention was just to see how I can help him, and I have done that. I just want to move on with my own life. So if you have anything else to give to Emmanuel, just contact him directly. And I want to say, follow his page, follow him up, whatever content he creates, follow it up. Just show him some love, because years back everyone was laughing at him, and now we all can find him, get access to him, and future him in whatever it is we think we can future him in. And thank you for watching. So after the interview, I took him out there for lunch. And Emmanuel is currently learning how to play badminton.
Go!
Better!
Fast!
Better!
Fast!
You don't play!
Pass it!
So he took me to the site where he plays badminton, introduced me to his coach, and then I watched Emmanuel play badminton. I was really happy to see that Emmanuel has now moved on after that very event. Emmanuel is now doing a lot of important things in the society.
I'm happy to see that Emmanuel has changed ever since. He didn't let that situation pull him down. If it were some people, they would have gotten depressed and maybe, you know what I'm talking about, but Emmanuel did not let that bring him down. Emmanuel is currently learning how to play badminton, so I went with him. I introduced me to his coach and I watched Emmanuel play badminton. So guys, let's support Emmanuel. Believe it or not, brothers and sisters, I think we just found the most courageous guy in the whole of Nigeria. There are times in our life where we'll be faced with opportunities and we'll begin to ask ourselves if we even measure up. But this was not the case for Emmanuel. When this opportunity came for Emmanuel, Emmanuel embraced it wholeheartedly. Emmanuel thought he was going to win. Unfortunately, Emmanuel did not win. I want to say that Emmanuel is a symbol of what every courageous guy should look like.